Highlight of the trip, what was it?
Nah, I think obviously playing a game, getting all the way over to London and having a win by a point was definitely a highlight.
What was it like pulling on the four jumper for the first time in anger?
Yeah, no, it was good fun. I think you know, the experience to go over there to London with a whole new teammates and get to know them on a different level was really good, and it was a really good trip.
I know there's not a lot hanging off the game, but just getting that win though, what does it do to a bit of confidence and build up going into the pre-season?
Oh yeah, I think it was definitely an exhibition game, and we're not getting carried away at all. You know, it was a bit of fun, and it was good to have a win.
I think after when he kicked the winning goal, Brad Ebbett kissed the black armband. It was a nice touch and a nice sort of tribute, I suppose.
Yeah, it was definitely a good touch. You know, I didn't know J-Mac too well, but all the boys said he was a great fella, and it was good to get a win for him.
What'd you get out of the trip, mate?
Like I said before, I think it was good to get to know some new teammates on a different level, and you know, we're training at Milan and London, we got to see some great sights and went to the Lord's Cricket Ground, which was great as well.
Having seen some of the Port players close up, who surprised you as maybe being better than you thought they might be?
I think there's a couple of young guys that seen him close up, Jasper Pittard, Maury, Youngie, all those sort of guys that played really well in the game. I think they can take their game to a new level next year.
So seeing him close up, obviously you've got a better impression of what they are like?
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, with training with guys, you have a lot more of a gauge of what sort of person and player they are as well.
Give us a bit of a rundown on how Ken Hinckley went in his first round. Be careful with it.
Yeah, no, Kenny sort of gave the reins over to Gotchi and let him have control of the game, but there wasn't too much coaching going on. It was more about just going out there, playing on instinct and having a bit of fun.
That was only one game. You think it's going to be positive next season, Angus, Port Adelaide?
Yeah, I definitely think so. I think, you know, Kenny and a new group of coaches and that sort of stuff, and hopefully some good kids in the draft who are going to help us a lot next year.
Did many of the guys notice a little change in the game style?
It was a fun game, an exhibition game, so we just got told to go out and have fun and enjoy ourselves.
Your former teammate Kyle Ramis said that the pre-season under the weapon was the hardest thing he's ever had to do. Yep. How did you find it?
Yeah, no, it was tough, but I think I'm looking forward to having a pre-season under Darren Burgess and seeing what he's got in store for us, so looking forward to it.
Another tough one, he sort of flagged it's going to be a pretty tough summer for the boys.
Yeah, I think obviously every pre-season is pretty tough, and it'll be a good initiation, I think, under Darren.
Angus, it's been a pretty tough time for the footy club performance-wise. Did you have a chance while you were away to sit down and talk about what the expectations are for this year, or is that to come later?
No, I think that's to come later. We sort of just did a little bit of training, got to know each other on a better level a bit more, and I think we're starting next Monday, so we'll start to get into the nitty and gritty things next week.
Angus, Ken Hinckley said he was going to try and use the trip to maybe sit down one-on-one with a lot of players and maybe talk about the year next year. Did he sit down with you at all and have a chat?
No, not really. Still haven't really talked too much about footy. It was more just to get to know each other at this point, so I'm looking forward to doing that next week.